So, okay, students. So, as I share to you that this one is a example of this XY scatter chart. So, I said to you, scatter chart are used to compare the values. What I said? Scatter chart are typically used for showing and comparing numerical values. Okay. Let me write it the theory part also. This is called scatter, S-C-A-T-T-E-R, scatter, and it is also called XY. So it is used for showing and comparing numerical values. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you? It is used for it is used for showing and comparing numerical values. So as by the definition, you can watch here that there are series 1, series 2, and if you click on this, so this represent these numbers. If you click on this, this number, so this will represent this number. So these dots are used for just comparing the numerical values and showing the numerical. Next one is donut chart, D-O-U. D-O-U-G-H-N-U-T, donut chart. So what does it mean, students? Basically,
one doubt is there that you are writing in a scattered chart that it is showing and comparing numerical values.
Yes.
Then in all chart it is showing that only. Means some subject has another number and some subject has another number.
Right. So Shnon, basically all the charts are the same aim. Little bit some differences are there. And their aims are same, and but the way of showing your data is different. Someone is making the pillar, someone is showing in a that means fractional part. So in these ways they are comparing the values. Is it clear? Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So what are donut chart? D-O-U-G-S, that means what I have written? D-O-U? Can you explain? Read it?
D-O-U-G-H-N-U-T.
Right. Chart. Okay. Yes. This chart shows the relationship of parts to a whole. It is, so can you differentiate between pie chart? Pie chart is also, the work of pie chart is also same. This chart shows the relationship of parts to whole, and it was the work of pie chart was same. Can you understand my point? Can you understand?
Yes.
Okay. So let me write the difference. This only difference that a donut chart. Can contain more than one data series. You know that. When I was writing the pie chart, so just remember these ones. Then I was writing only one data. Do you remember this one? Do you remember?
No. One data means?
Let me write something for you. Wait. So that you can make the differentiate between them. with suppose if there are a students like Ramesh, Mohan, okay, Rakesh, Pramod, Vinod, and their marks is like this: 23, 34, 45, 78. And I just select to these data, go to insert, and go to pie chart. Then you can see here there was the relation between these Mohan, Rakesh, Pramod, and Vinod, and these their numbers was allocating in the pie chart by the fractions. So how was the fractions? I have sent the videos, and also I explained to you how they were related. So how they were related, students? Can you tell me how this? I have written one formula also. Do you remember? Do you remember the formula, friends? Do you remember the formula, please?
No.
How you find out the fractional part? That means percentage. You will add these all. How you will do?
Yes.
Equal to SUM. Add these all numbers. Then after that, what you will do?
Enter.
No, no. Multiply 100, then divide by. Divide by. Okay. No, I'm sorry. You just add it. Enter button. This 180 is the addition. Then what happened for the average? For the average of this one, equal to. You will write the you will write the formula like 23. And 23 divided by this number. This number is having that means no changing. That means it will have the dollar sign.
Sir.
Dollar. Yes, yes. Dollar in front of all. Dollar. Then after that, there will be the multiplication of 100 and press enter button. You got 12.77, and just increase this. You can get these all. 12.77, 18, 25, 43. These are the fractional part. And if you can see here the fractional part like this, you just see here. 13, 19, 25, and 43. You just see here. 12, after decimal there are 7. That means it becomes 13. After decimal there is 8, it becomes 19. There is 25. After 43, there are 3. So it remains 43. Just see here. 43, 13, 90%, and 25%. Yes, tell your question. Ask your question. Ask your question.
When you are clicking on 23 for finding the average,
mm-hmm.
then they are coming 19, and 180, then they are coming as 13.
19. So I have written this formula. I have written this formula better. 23 divide by 180 and multiply 100. So first time this will be there, and the second time 34. So it will change to 34. 33 is changed to 34. Then again 40, 34 changed to 45, and again 45 changed to 78. Do you know the formula of for getting the percentage? This is percentage, na? 43%, 34. Do you know the formula of for getting the percentage? Your part divide by complete part multiply 100. Do you know this thing?
Yes.
Do you know or not? Just tell your answer.
Yes, no.
You know? Or just so you know?
Yes.
Okay, so same formula I applied. 23 divide by 180 multiply 100. 34 divide by 180 multiply 100. So by this way you get the fraction part. Is it clear? Clear,
yes.
Beta? Okay, very good. So So students, here you can watch this. You can watch that there are only one values. Here Mohan is having in only one subject marks 23, 34, 45, 78. So by this way you can use the pie chart. But if you want to use that means more than one number, so in that case you will use which chart? DOU, GH, NU, T. Okay, so suppose I am writing more number 67, 78, 98, 90. One more I have written 44, 66, 88, 99. So these are the number, these are the three numbers. Let me make the pie chart, then you will see there is a problem. Just see, watch here, pie chart. You can see here, pie chart is not showing the other values. Can you see this? Can you see, students? Or just see?
Yes, that one. Yes.
It is not showing the all the values. Can it is showing? Is it showing?
Yes.
No, it is not showing. This is showing only the values like first one. Just watch here. This first one, only 34, 45, 78. It is not showing the value 67, 78. Where you are getting the all the fractions? These are only 1, 2, 3, 4. This is only for 1. This one, you can just click on this. This is highlighted. This one is highlighted. These two values are not highlighted. Can you understand my point?
Yes.
That means it is not used. These are not used. So how this will use? This will use the another chart which I am explaining. Let me make this one. Go to insert. Go to other chart. There are this one. Just watch here. You can see here right now. There are different. You can see first one, second one, third one. So third one is representing this highlighted. Then second one is representing this one. And the third one is representing this one. Can you understand this point? Can you understand better?
Sir.
Yes, ask your question.
Only one subject that is showing mark.
No, beta. Just see here, watch here. The first ring represents the first data series, and the second ring represents the second data series, and the third ring represents the third data series, and these facts. Then you can see the small fraction. These are the percentage. It's very simple, students. Very simple.
Yes.
Right now you can you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. You all can understand what I am saying? You all can understand what I am saying? Other students. They are not listening. Ojasvi, are you listening?
Yes.
Your concept is clear?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So the first ring representing which value? This first one. Second one, this one. And the third one, this one. You can see here, when you are clicking on the first ring, automatically the first data series is highlighted. Second you click, second data series. Third you click, third data series. It's very simple, and there are different parts. You can see here, this part represents, if you click in different way, fractional part. You just, okay, wait. If I go to this one, and sorry, this is other chart. Not short.
Sir?
Yes, wait, let me do something. Hey, wait 1 minute. Okay, this show the fractional part, this one. You can see here the fractional part also. 25%, 23, 22, 19, 30, 43, 77. Yes, ask your question.
In doubt net chart.
Mm-hmm.
So many datas are there?
Huh, in .NET chart, you can plot many data series. This, you can see this data series, You can see this data series. You can see this data series. You can see, na? Just this first ring. This is the first ring representing this one. This is the second ring representing this one. This is the third ring representing this one. You can see. Doubt is clear.
Achha.
Is your doubt clear?
Yes.
Okay. So in the next video, I will explain the radar chart. Should I explain today radar chart? Give me 1 minute. I will explain. Can I explain?
Yes, explain, sir.
Okay. Just delete one. Not delete. Switch to switch. Change chart type. And here is, where is radar? This one. You can click on this one. Okay. This is converted to radar chart. So basically, students, these are the data variables, Mohan, Rakesh, Pramod. So these are represented on the axis. This Vinod, Rakesh, Mohan, and Pramod. Okay? And this 23, 34, this one. These are the values. So these are the points. 23, this one. You can see the data. This is so these first one, this is the data series first one. And you just see here. This is the data series third one. And just see here. This is the data series. This second one. You can see. Can you see this?
Yes.
Okay. So what are the radar chart? Radar chart compare the aggregate values of several data series. I can write here the theory part. Radar chart. It compares the aggregate values of several data series. So you can see, students, what your this chart looks similar to a spider net. You can see this is a spider, just like a spider net. And it displays the data values plotted as the points which are connected lines to form a grid. These are the data values. Just see here. This point. Can you see this one? This one, this one, this one, this one. So these are connected through a line. Is it clear to you? So data values are the points which are connected lines to form a grid. Can you see this one? Just see this data. This one, this one. This one, this one. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay. So the radar chart compares the aggregate values of several data series. It is useful for comparing data that is not time dependent but shows different circumstances such as a variable. What I am written, this is, you just remember this one. It compares the aggregate value of several data series. So these are the data series. First one, second one, third one. You can watch here. This first one represent the first one, second represent the third one, and the last represent this one. Okay. Okay. So this compares the aggregate values of several data series. So these represent the, and these are the that means variables. Mohan, Rakesh, Pramod, and Vinod. These are on the axis. This one you can see here. Mohan, Rakesh, Pramod. And this will represent the data values, and it is connected through a lines and to form a grid. So these are the third one series. So basically, it compares the aggregate values of different data series. Is it clear right now? Is it clear? It compares the aggregate values of different data series. Just remember this. It compares aggregate values of different data series. So this is one data series, this one, this all, this is second data series, and this is third one data series. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. First one, second one, and third one. So these points is represent data. These points represent data. Is it clear?
But sir, how we can say not understanding this?
Actually, this makes a spider. So that's why you cannot. Let me show you some more points. Students, if you remove these two variables from here, just watch here. Let me first delete it and remove these two variables. Then if you make, if you want to make the radar chart, then it will not form. So the main condition for making the radar chart, you must have more than one data variable, more than two data variables. Just watch here. If I make the radar chart, go to radar, you can see, I'm sorry, if it is forming a triangle. Just watch here what it is forming. This is not in the form of like a spider. This is not in the form of hexagon, pentagon. This is in the form of triangle. Can you see this? Because it is having how many variable, how many data series? 1, 2, and 3. But if you delete one more, let me show you. Just delete one and delete this one. Just watch this one. Go to other radar. It is forming a line. Can you see this one? So that means for making a radar chart, you must have more than two data series. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Clear to you? Okay. So this is the end of the today's class, and I will discuss the students stock chart and bubble chart and surface chart in the next class. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Yes, beta.
You told to give the question answer of lesson 1, 2, 1 and 2.
Okay, let me complete this chapter first. Let me complete this chapter. Okay. So thank you, friends. Thank you for joining.
Thank you.
And you should watch also the videos also. Okay.
Thank you.